हेलो फ्रेंड्स, द Q1 FY14 परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ द टेलीकॉम कंपनीज वॉज अबव आवर एक्सपेक्टेशंस ऑन ऑल द फ्रंट. द टू कंपनीज विच वी ट्रैक्ड वेरी क्लोजली, दैट इज भारती एयरटेल एंड आइडिया सेलुलर, दे परफॉर्म ओवर एक्सपेक्टेशन ऑन वेरियस ग्राउंड्स. वेन वी टेक इन टू अकाउंट बोथ द कंपनीज, भारती एयरटेल एज वेल एज आइडिया सेलुलर, अ स्ट्रॉन्ग परफॉर्मेंस इन द रेवेन्यू ग्रोथ वॉज सीन, एडेड बाय अ robust uptake in the price, wherein we saw price realization growth staggering between 4-6% for the players, with a muted volume growth which ranged between 2-3%. This was basically because of the anvil of early monsoon along with the steep rise in the price that we had seen. So as expected, we were expecting the realizations to increase, but the realization increase that came in was much above our estimates. We were expecting around 1-1.5% price rise to happen in the industry, whereas the price rise that happened was around 4-6%, as I talked about. So led by the price realization and volume growth, the overall top line growth for both the players, that is Bharti Airtel's Indian business, that is domestic wireless business, was around 5.2%, whereas Idea's business growth or the revenue growth was around 7.9% on a sequential basis. So very good performance as far as the revenue was concerned for both the players. Now revenue performance along with the price rise in the voice segment also had data had a role to play in it. Data growth continued to remain strong as seen in the last two quarters. For this particular quarter, the data growth, the sequential data growth was around 18-20% for the players, and data's contribution to the overall revenue has also increased and now stands at around 8-10% for various players. So data along with the pricing power that is coming back to the players, that had led to a good amount of revenue growth. On the margins profile front, if we look at the players' performance for this particular quarter, Bharti as well as Idea, they both surprised positively on the margins front. Bharti's margin was up by 60 to 70 basis point on the India on an overall basis, while the India business margin was up around 90 basis point. And in case of Idea Cellular, the margin performance was much stronger. The margin came in at surprise at around margin came in at a positive, that is expansion of around 450 basis point on a sequential basis, beating even the most optimistic expectations on the street. So more than Bharti, Idea's performance was much higher than what the street as well as we were expecting. Now in the management in the conference call, both the management for Bharti Airtel as well as Idea Cellular, they sounded quite confident on the improving competitive environment of the domestic business. In case of Bharti, the African business continues to be under pressure. We have seen in the last quarter's results as well as this quarter's results as well. So on the Africa side, things are not that great for Bharti, but yes, the Indian environment looks very promising, very robust. Again, in the Idea's conference call, the management sounded very confident on the improving business environment. Both the management stated that the industry is likely to maintain the pricing discipline which has been seen in last two quarters. So overall, the environment on the competitive side, on the business side, is improving. On the regulatory fronts also, number of initiatives have been taken by the government, and we believe that the regulatory environment has also become little benign than what it was earlier, though still a lot of clarity needs to be done on the regulatory front. Now keeping in mind the first quarter FY14 performance, the management commentary and our analysis, what we have done is we have raised Bharti Airtel's India business EBITDA margin and India business EBITDA, which leads to upgrade the EBITDA estimates for Bharti, and hence our new target price for Bharti is now 350 rupees. As far as Idea is concerned, Idea's performance, as I talked about, was a very good performance for Idea. It was a blowout quarter on all the three fronts, revenue, margin as well as PAT level, and hence taking into account this strong up move which it has already seen in first quarter, plus the strong execution capabilities of Idea Cellular, we have raised all the three estimates for Idea Cellular by around 15%. So overall, we continue to like the telecom sector because of the improving business environment and less harsh regulatory environment. So we maintain a positive view on telecom sector. As far as the stocks are concerned, we prefer Idea Cellular on first preference. We give Idea as a first preference as compared to Bharti, because Idea has shown a strong execution strength overall, and it continues to upbeat Bharti in various front. Along with that, it is also a pure wireless play that makes us more positive on Idea. While for Bharti's India business, we continue to have a very positive view, and it has also demonstrated quite positive momentum in the last two quarters, but its African business continues to be a dragger for it. Along with the African business, the exchange rate movement, the volatile exchange rate movement which we are seeing right now, also caps return for Bharti Airtel. And hence, though we continue to like Bharti Airtel, we continue with our hold recommendation on the stock with a target price of 350 rupees. While for Idea Cellular, we maintain a positive view as it is not in our active coverage list. Thank you.